those of you who got an invite, welcome to Nerd Prom.
No matter where in the world you are, we're all Nerds International. With the hyphen.
Okay, so basically, unit placement, we're going to roll as for initiative, and the one with the lower result has to go first. Whoops.
Box cards.
I'm probably going to roll off the table. No, I'm not. Wow. Okay, so I have to go first, and I say we go with the alternate rules for placement, so we start on the map, but within 5 hexes of your border. So I have to go first, which means I am going to start with my Valkyrie. Bloody chat window. And start at that. Is that 5 hexes? Yeah. And start with the Valkyrie up here. Right. Then you play some mech, then I play some mech, and so on. And then we go shoot the living daylights out of each other. Let's see if that was a big mistake or if it wasn't.
Now, what about elevated?
Not
a penalty?
Not when placing. It costs more movement to move up a level or down a level, I think. But not when placing. Not with the initial unit placing.
And it's from within the entire side of the board, right? Not a corner?
Yeah, nope, not a corner, just the entire line. Within 5 hexes, that's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7.
I thought it was 10. Oh, 10 inches, that's fine. Okay.
Not your movement. For initial placing, it's within 5 hexes of your border, so to say. Okay, so there. I'm going to drop awesome right in here. Let's see how that works. Oh, crap, can't do that. Sorry, my bad. That's way too much distance. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Yeah, right here. Okay. Your turn. Ooh. Sniper on the deck. Five. Okay. You are going 1, 2, 3, 4 over here. Crap.
Okay, I'm done placing your move.
Okay, now we reroll for initiative for the first round and see what happens. Have a 9, 6. Nice. So that means you move first. You get the first move of one of your units. Then I move a unit. Then you move a unit, and so on.
Okay, your turn.
Right. He moves up. So the. Could have printed these out for me. Living and learning. Right.
Actually, if you go back to where all your cards are,
yeah,
and you hit Control 1, it'll save it as a camera. So every time you want to go back, you just hit Shift 1 to go back.
Oh, thank you. I did not know that.
So you can do that with all of the numbers. I don't know how far up, how many cameras there are, but I think there's at least 5. So you can do like Control 1, Control 2, Control 3, and it'll save all those different cameras.
That is really cool. Thank you. Hello. Okay, so... Okay, must remember to press the correct button. Okay, so if I do this, and I do this. Nice. Okay, the Hunchback moves 8. So, okay, that's interesting. They don't seem to convert everything to hexes, but only some things. So, meaning if I have 8 inches to walk with the Hunchback, each normal hex would cost me 2 inches, and each hex with wood on it would cost me 3 inches. That's a little cumbersome. So that would be 2, 4, and 7 inches, which doesn't give me much of a firing arc, but yeah. Well, your turn. Yay for locusts. Meep meep. Okay. Awesome as movement 6, Marona has 8. So 6. Right, so 3 inches to walk here, another 3 to walk here. Okay.
The water is 2.
Deep water is... That's a good question. Hello. The shallow water doesn't do anything. The deep water adds plus 1 inch to the movement it costs you to move. The water level 1 is just like base level ground. Water level 2 adds another inch to movement. Also, water level 2 is considered so deep that the mech is completely submerged, so it blocks line of sight, both in and out.
No.
Okay. Ah, fuck it. 2... 3, 4, 7, and like this. Okay, done.
My Warhammer is gonna stay.
Okay. Then Valkyrie is going to be moving hopefully really fast. That thing can move 10, so 5 hexes, and jumping ignores stuff like rough terrain or elevation, so it's just 5 hexes. This 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Hiding in the woods. Okay, movement is done. So now is the firing phase, which once again starts with the one who lost initiative. So we start with you. But damage actually only takes effect at the end of the round. So now you fire with everything you want at my max, and I'll note down the damage, but it doesn't take effect until at the end of the round when I had a chance to return fire, because it's considered to all happen simultaneously.
Okay, how do the range work?
Range increments are the same for every mech. Short range is 0 to 3 hexes away. Medium range is 4 to 12 hexes away, and long range is 13 to 21 hexes away. So short range doesn't add any modifier to the roll. Medium range adds plus 4, long range adds medium range adds plus 2, and long range adds plus 4. Plus anything like partial cover and what else? If one of your mechs would have jumped, that also modifies the attack roll.
Oh, okay. So my it's going to be long range. My long range plus 4. There's 2. Does that mean that plus 2 instead of a plus 4?
So if I'm at long range, means you make your attack roll with a plus 4 and you deal 2 damage if you hit.
Okay, and what am I rolling to hit?
You have a basic skill of 4, so you roll 2d6. You basically always roll 2d6. And the standard target number you have to beat is a 4 to hit, and any modifier gets added onto that. So if you're firing at long range with no other modifiers, it's a 4 for your basic skill, plus 4 for the long range, so you have to beat an 8 with 2d6.
Okay. I guess I'll say which one I'm attacking. Let's see. My Atlas is going to shoot at your hunchback.
So then we have to go check if you have line of sight, which you do have. But there's also, there's also the woods in between, so that counts as partial cover, and I'm standing in front of the elevated terrain, which is also partial cover, but I don't think that adds up. It's either you have partial cover or you don't, at least as far as I read it, and if that is wrong, then I'm just going to do it wrong for the moment. So partial cover adds another plus 2, so you're going to need
a 10. This does not look very promising.
Well, it is long range. Nope,
got a 5.
Right, so every mech has one attack. So, that was the Atlas. So, which one would you like to try next?
Oh, I shoot all of them first at that attack.
No, only movement is back and forth between the players, but the firing phase is you go with everything you have.
All right, my locust will shoot at you.
Nine. Yeah, which is medium range. So 4 plus 2, 6 with that. Yeah, you need an 8 to hit.
That's
a 7. Nope.
My Warhammer. Or no. Yeah, Shadow. Hunchback. Is that medium?
2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14. That's 18 hexes to the hunchback.
That's long range, okay. Alright. That's gonna be a 10.
Yeah, 18 is going to be long range.
And I don't get it.
Nope.
Let's see.
So that leaves your Shadowhawk, I think, which can't do anything.
No, the Warhammer. Oh, that's right. Yeah. Okay. Yeah. My turn's done.
Yep. Right. Let's see. So, Linus. Good question. Does the Valkyrie have long-range fire? I don't think so.
Is there an advantage to being at a higher elevation also?
Probably, because it makes the line of sight a lot easier. But
it's probably more advanced rules.
Yeah, it's probably more advanced. I'm not sure if the advanced rules go that far with elevation. I think they're more concerned with cover and stuff. At the moment, it just makes it really easy for me to target you, I think. Let's see how it plans out. I can hit anything well. Oh wow, the Valkyrie actually can do 1 damage over long range. So, do you have any sort of cover up there from the Valkyrie? No. So that's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. 16 hexes, which is totally long range. Great, so I need an 8 to hit you with the Valkyrie, which I'm going to try. Wow, and I do. Guess the Valkyrie has some LRMs or something. So I'm inflicting 1 point of damage to your Warhammer, sir. Which means he now has 1 point less of his crap ton of armor.
Wait, the Warhammer? Isn't he submerged? Or is that the Shadowhawk?
The Shadowhawk is submerged.
Okay.
Okay, so I am going to... So my Marauder is going to target the Locust. And from... Well, I guess he has partial cover from the trees, because they are in the way, so that's another plus 2 for cover, so that's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 13 points of distance, which is exactly long range, so I'm going to need a 10 to hit the Locust. Nope. That is not going to happen. So then the awesome is trying to hit, I guess I'm also trying to hit the Locust. 9, 10, 12, 13, and it's also long range. God bloody damn it. And he also has cover for the trees, so another 10. Nope. And the hunchback can't see shit, probably. Now I can see the Warhammer. '14, '15, '16, '17, '18. Okay, long range with also cover because we have elevated terrain between us and the woods, so yeah, another 10. Lots of 10s in this initial firing phase. Bloody hell!
Nice.
Wow. So, at long range with a hunchback... Oh, okay. Strike what I said. The hunchback is firing wild because he doesn't have long range capability. Which I thought he would have, because an autocannon 20 usually can do that, but not an alpha strike. So, nothing happens. Right, so, next initiative phase. An 11. Wow.
Okay. This isn't going very good for me.
Well, it's your move, sir. I'm going to have to do so much cutting and editing on this video, probably. So where am I going to go? There's a movement of 8. Going to... That is 3 inches and another 3 inches. And that's all I can do with him. So I move the hunchback and I'm done. Oh, and ha! I totally forgot something in the first round for the first round of engagements. Wow, I forgot the movement modifiers. Cool, something to think of for the next round of fire. Because
for shooting, you mean?
Yeah, because the faster a mech can move, the harder it is to hit if it moves. It's not like in classic Battletech, where the modifier is determined by how much you actually move. It's just a flat modifier that is applied if you move at all. And for example, the modifier, it's noted on the sheets as... what does it say? TMM, the to move modifier. So the to move modifier for a locust is a 3. So if your locust moves, that's a +3 for me to hit him. Just because the bloody thing moved. That thing is fast. It's going to be hell to hit.
Okay. It's your turn to move.
Yep. And... some can move 6. So that is 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3.
Done. How does love it?
Each level of elevation you traverse adds 1 inch to the movement cost. And when you finish your movement, you can change the direction of your mech in the facing of your mech in any direction you want. So changing the direction your mech is facing doesn't cost any actual movement. Okay, so the Marauder has a movement of 8. Let's see. It's 2, 4, 6, 7, 8, because it's also woods. All right.
Okay.
So, and if you don't have jump jets, I think you can traverse a maximum of one level of height per step. So you can't go from level 3 to level 1 terrain to take the long way around. Okay. And all that does is leave my Valkyrie, which has a movement of 10, and it can jump, which is really nice because it allows me to ignore terrain. So that's 5 hexes in action 1, 2, 3, 4. Five. Yeah, sure. Let's go over here and face that way. And I'm done. So, firing phase.
All right, the Atlas is going to shoot at your Marauder.
Wait. So that's plus 2 because I'm still within the woods, which counts as cover.
That's 6, 7, 8.
Plus the movement because I moved, which is another 1, so that would be a 9. Nope.
6.
Man, hitting stuff is a lot more difficult than I thought it would be.
Yeah, the Shadow Hawk is gonna shoot at your Marauder also.
It's also medium range, plus 2, plus cover, plus 2, plus 1, so 2.
Nope.
Nope.
And the Locust will shoot at the Hunchback. That's medium. Plus 2 for terrain.
Yeah, so that's also plus 5, I think, because yeah, Hunchback, yeah, it's also 1. So yeah, so that's also a 9 to hit. Well, the numbers to hit are getting lower. Not much, but they're getting lower. Crap.
To hit.
Right, so how much damage do you do, sir, on medium range?
One. One.
Well, that's 1 point of armor gone.
Better than nothing, I suppose.
Yep.
Now, for my Warhammer, your Valkyrie is out of line of sight, right?
I don't think so. That's
Because of the
elevation.
facing.
Oh, right. Hold on, let me check the firing arcs. I think those were rather liberal in Alpha Strike. Firing arcs. Nope. If I'm not, hold on a second. I'm gonna paint a line. Nope. If I'm in, that's probably not the line I wanted to draw. Nope. 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 To paint. Nope. Damn it. Why doesn't this work like I want it to? So basically, that is the. If I'm in front of this line, you can shoot me.
Okay, so it's
Because you
just the
can.
back.
Yeah, because the back. So because you can traverse your torso to either side. So it's a rather big arc of fire. So you
All right,
have,
so my Atlas will shoot at your Valkyrie.
yeah,
That's long
which,
range.
yeah, but doesn't have
I don't see. I
any.
don't know if these. Yeah, I don't know
I,
if the woods would count as cover since we're both elevated.
they would count as cover if we were both at level 1 elevation, but since you are at a level 2 elevation, I'd say you have perfect line of sight without, we have line of sight to each other without cover. So if it's long range, that's plus 4 for the long range. And the Valkyrie moved, and the movement modifier is A2, so that is plus 6, so that is a 10 to hit, sir. God damn it! And he hits with boxcars. Damn it! Right, what's your long range damage?
Long range is 2.
Oh my god, I still have armor on the Valkyrie. I don't believe it.
Yeah, just don't get into medium range.
I'm not planning to. Not after this hit. Okay, so the Valkyrie is going to return the favor, which means it's going to be long range, no cover, and I'm guessing your move modifier is 1.
Where is that? TMM?
The TMM, yep.
Yeah, okay, that's a 1.
Right, so
for the Atlas.
That's a 9 to hit with the Valkyrie. Nope. Right, then I think I'm going to do a lot of shooting on your Atlas. Or am I? Not. I could try
the Atlas or the Warhammer?
Oh, the Atlas, because he doesn't have cover from the Marauder. And it doesn't matter for the Awesome because there's woods in between. Or I could try to take down the Shadowhawk. Huh. You know what, I'm going to try to take out the Shadowhawk. So let's start with the Marauder. That is basically... Is that cover? Nope. That is no cover. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. That's medium range, so that's plus 2. And the TMM should be 1, I guess.
For who? The Shadowhawk?
For the Shadowhawk, yep.
No, it's 2.
It's 2? Wow. Fast bugger. Right, so that's plus 4, so that's an 8 to hit. Let's see. Nope. Okay, then the Awesome is going to fire, which has an additional plus 2 because I'm going to shoot through woods, so that's going to be a 10 to hit. Nope. And the Hunchback, same deal, no woods but elevated terrain, so also a 10 to hit. Nope.
Are any rules for critical failures?
Not that I know of, thank God. Okay.
Yeah, you gain heat. That's right. Shooting weapons accrues heat, right?
Nope. Totally forgot. Shooting your normal attacks doesn't generate heat. You have a value on your mech sheets called OV. It's to the left of the heat scale.
Okay, my Warhammer has 1.
Right, that means your Warhammer can inflict 1 additional point of damage over short and medium distances, but generates 1 heat that way.
Okay.
So for most mechs, doesn't matter, they are well balanced, they can fire their weapons without generating any heat, but some mechs can do additional damage over short and medium distance, but generate heat that way.
How do you reduce heat?
By not firing for an entire round, or by stepping into water. If you are at least in level 1 water, you reduce your heat by 1 point at the end of the round. Okay, so I think we're through. New initiative. 4. Yeah, that's what I thought. Still take another 5 jump, that would be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, that's not good. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, that's not good either. The Valkyrie is going to jump over here, and yeah, we'll keep facing that way.
Two, three.
You start up there, right? So
yeah, this is where I started up.
Yeah, one going one forward and one level down is 3 inches, and then another 3 inches you would be down. Oh, that's 2, 4, 6, that's 6 inches, yeah, or 3 hexes. Yeah, I probably should have seen that move coming. Oh god. Bye bye, Valkyrie. It was nice knowing you. Oh well. It distracted the Warhammer for a while, so meh. It's the Marauder 1, which can't jump, I think. Nope. Just has 8 movement. So that's. 6. Yeah, the Marauder is going to try to find cover.
You said level 1 water is no effect?
Yep. At least not that I could find anything about it. Oh, hi!
Oh, no, I can't go there. That's one extra movement. I forgot about going down the elevation.
Ah. Well, that's still rather close. Interesting. The awesome has exactly 6 inches movement, which is nice, which means I can take 3 step forward and another 3 step forward and be done. Yep. Bloody hell, that thing is so freaking fast! I could probably kill every other mech in your lands and the locust would be still standing and dancing around me and singing while I can't hit it because it's so fast. Oh god. Okay, so the hunchback has a movement of 8. That thing isn't even that slow. But it's 3, 5, 8. Yeah, still have cover. All right, cool. Well. This is going to hurt. Don't know whom yet, but it's going to hurt. Alright, so the Valkyrie is going to fire on the Warhammer. 6.
Plus 1.
Plus 1. 6 is medium range, so plus 2 there, plus... So yeah, plus 3, so that is... God damn it. A 7 to hit. Let me pick up my dice. And it hits with a 9. So at medium range, the Valkyrie does 2 damage.
To the Warhammer?
Yeah, to the Warhammer.
Alright.
Alright, then a whole lot of fire on the Shadowhawk. The Marauder is of course going to fire on the Shadowhawk, which is short range, but plus 2 for partial cover because of the elevation, and plus 2 because the Shadowhawk is moving really fast. So plus 4, so that's an 8. And it can't hit the broadside of a barn. Which a Shadowhawk at this distance literally is. Damn it. 1, 2, 3, 4. Ah, damn it. Okay, the Awesome is also going to fire on the Shadowhawk, but that is actually medium range. And also plus 2 for that, so that is a plus 6. So that is a 10 to hit. Which it fails at miserably. And then that leaves the Hunchback, which is going to fire... Short range, but... Locust has like, what the... Oh, for God. So either I take a shot at the Atlas at plus 2... No, plus 3, plus 3 on the Atlas, or plus 4 on the Locust. You know what? I'm going to try to hit the Locust, because that would be 4 damage if I can hit it. So that would be short range, but plus 4 for movement, no cover. Yeah, it's an 8. Okay.
His movement is 3.
Oh, it's only a 3? Oh, yeah. Nice. Then it's a 7 to hit. Huh. Maybe I can do that. Exactly a 7. That would be 4 damage to the Locust.
That destroys it.
Wow. Whoa, that was lucky.
But he still gets an opportunity to shoot back.
Yeah, he still gets an opportunity to shoot back. He is only destroyed at the end of the round. So that was all my firing. It's your turn, sir.
Okay, I'll start with my Warhammer on your Valkyrie.
Right.
Which is medium range.
And plus 2 for movement, so it's a plus 4 to hit. So an 8. Ouch.
There it is.
How much damage?
That's three
damage. Oh my God, it's still alive with 1 point of internal structure left.
Yeah, but I think I'm going to spend 1 eat to make it more.
Okay. Oh,
how does that work?
I forgot to tell you. Technically, you have to tell me that before you fire, but you didn't know that because I screwed up in telling you. So we will assume you told me
you
that.
You know what?
Blasted. Okay.
No, that's okay, because I don't think I would have if I didn't. I only did it because I saw the result, right? So even if I. Yeah, I wouldn't count it, no.
Okay, then you have to roll another 2d6 to determine, or do I roll it myself? I think I roll it myself. No, you roll it. You inflicted the damage. You may roll the critical hit.
Oh, you get a critical? How does that work?
Every time a hit does damage to the internal structure of a mech, you roll for a critical hit. So I had 1 point of armor left, which got blasted away. Then I took 2 points of structural damage, so it's a critical hit, and that is a 6, which will be a weapon hit. Damn it! Good thing I fired first. So I'm going to have so weapon, which means I am doing now 1 damage less. If I'm alive. Oh, well, technically, yeah, I'm going
to be
alive. Right?
My locust is going to shoot at your hunchback.
Yep.
That's short range. Plus movement, so that's going to be 3. Plus, are you in terrain?
Yeah, I'm in. Still in the woods, so that's +2 for the woods.
That's a 5 to hit.
Five.
Any hits?
No.
For 1 point.
It's a 4 base. +2 for cover is a 6. And +1 for movement
and
is
movement
a 7.
7.
Yep,
okay.
It's a 7.
So that's a miss. Alright.
Shame.
Then the Atlas will shoot at the hunchback, which is medium.
Yep.
So that's going to be a base of 6. Plus your movement is 7, 8, 9.
Yep. Nope.
And a miss. And the Shadowhawk will shoot at the Marauder.
Yeah.
Which short range. 4, 5 for movement, right?
Yep.
And then
7 because of the elevated terrain in between us. That is a 7!
See, Shadowhawk short range, 2 damage.
There goes my paint job. Alright. So, can you just flip it? So, yep, that one gets.
Yeah, you can flip it. I'm just trying to.
Flip.
Oh, you know what? You've got it turned off in your tabletop.
Yeah, I think I turned that up. As no matter, we'll just remove it from the battlefield. Doesn't really matter. I don't think down mechs count as cover or something. At least not that I would have read about it. All right, let's go. That would be an 8 to a 7. You go first. Yeah, why not? So that's 2, 4, and 7 movement. All right, I move the hunchback. Let's see. Awesome has a movement of 6. Since it really doesn't matter, I'm going to move here for 3 and here for... Oh, I don't even have to do that. Yep. Also moved.
Let me rotate this guy a little.
Oh, this is going to hurt probably a lot. Damn it. Okay, so the Marauder is going to... move one here and one here. And it's going to rotate like this for this round. Okay.
How are you rotating them?
With the,
I'm using Q and E. Is there another way?
Yeah, no, I'm using Q and E also. I think you can also rotate them with the mouse wheel when you have them picked up. But I'm just using Q and E.
Actually, I think you were supposed to move first since you have more mechs than me, right?
That is true. Which means I would have had to move 2 mechs. Now, okay, then I'm just going to move the Valkyrie also now, and yeah, then it's your turn.
Okay. The Warhammer is going to shoot at the Valkyrie. Medium range. So movement. 6, 7. Plus you're in the woods. 8, 9.
Nope.
Ooh. That's a miss. Shadowhawk's gonna shoot at the Marauder.
Right. That is 3, that's medium range, so plus 2, cover, plus 4, and he moved plus another 1, so that is a 9 to hit. Nope.
That's a miss. And the Atlas is going to shoot at the Awesome.
Same thing, also a 9. Wow, that's unlucky.
Another 8. That stinks. Your turn.
Wow. Okay. 7. Well, I guess the Valkyrie is going to shoot at the Shadowhawk. That is medium range, where I can still do damage. Only at medium range, which is plus 2 for range, and the Shadowhawk has a TMM of 2, I think. So that's plus 4, so that's an 8 to hit. Let's see. Nope. That pilot isn't having any of it. Okay, so the question is, does the Marauder even see the Atlas still, or did I block myself seeing it? There's a lot of cover in between there. The high cover. No, I think if I could rotate the camera downwards enough, I think I would see less than a third of the Atlas, so I can't shoot that one, which sucks. Which means I'm either going to have to shoot the Warhammer through woods or the Shadowhawk over elevated terrain, which doesn't make a bloody difference. I am trying to hit the Shadowhawk that is medium range. Plus 2, elevated terrain in between, plus 4, plus and another plus 2 because Shadowhawk. So it's a 10 to hit, and I'm going to use my overheat value of 1. For an additional point of damage if I can hit, because I'm standing in water, I don't generate heat. So 10 to hit with a potential of 4 damage. Yes! That is a 10, that would be 4 points of damage. To the Shadowhawk.
Program. 4 to the Shadowhawk, you said?
Yep.
Alrighty then.
Still has armor left. Okay. Well then, the Awesome 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 is going to shoot the Atlas. That is 2 for medium range and another 1 because it moved. So that is a 7 to hit. Go. Nope. And the Hunchback all the same. Range and a 7, and that will hit on a medium range. The Hunchback deals 3 damage to the Atlas.
Is that all of your shooting?
Yep. That was everything. So, movement. And it's neat. Wasn't there some kind of movement? Unequal number of units. This is. Okay, unequal number of units only applies if I have double your number or triple your number of units. As it seems. So.
So that doesn't affect initiative then?
For the moment, it doesn't affect initiative. If you would lose another mech, then there would be a different order. Wow.
Oh, man.
Oh, that's harsh.
I'm getting screwed. Alright.
It's basically the opposite of what I thought would happen. To this point.
Shadowhawk, jump in.
Alright, that means he can ignore the additional point cost for terrain. Yeah. I think... Well, it's medium range. Medium range is not so little, actually. Medium range is 4 to 12. Which means the Valkyrie is also going to jump. 1, 2, 3. And it's going to jump over here. It can still be annoying at medium range, hopefully. If the pilot snaps out of it and starts to roll worth a damn. Yeah, that's not going to be pretty at all. I think the Hunchback is just going to move one step to the side in the woods and see what will happen. Okay, so the Marauder is going to take one step forward, and the Awesome is going to... 4, Alright. That concludes my movement. Come at me, sir.
Alright, I'll start with the Shadowhawk shooting at the Marauder.
Alright. That is medium range and another plus one six, for movement. Seven. That's a 7 to hit.
Picking up the other dice.
That looks like a hit. Yes, it does. All right, that is how much damage?
Let's see. Medium range is 2.
Still some armor left on that one.
The Warhammer is going to shoot at the Marauder, and it is going to spend heat to add damage.
All right. That is, yeah.
That's going to be.
No cover, so yeah, the same, plus 3, so yeah, a 7 to hit. Oh, yeah. Ah, interesting that the tilted one counts as a 4, but yeah, wouldn't have mattered, 4 or 5. Alright, that is, I assume I think the technical term is a crap ton of damage. How much exactly would that be?
So that's, he normally does 3, and then if you add 1 for the heat, that's 4.
Alright, then roll 2d6 for the critical hit.
An 8
on a is a weapon hit. Damn it. So the Marauder is looking really rough and had a gun blown off, which is never fun. So what is your Atlas going to do?
Well, the Atlas, I think, is going to shoot the Marauder.
Yeah, I think that is a viable course of action, which would be a 9 to hit. Which is exactly what you rolled, sir.
So, the Atlas at medium range does 5 damage.
And that would be one less Marauder on this field of battle. Ouch. Right,
so mess with the best, die like the rest.
Message received. Okay. Well, it gets to return fire before taking the final journey. Okay, but I'm going to start with the Valkyrie. 1, 2, 3. 7, 8, 9, 10. Now, I'm going to shoot the Shadowhawk with the Valkyrie, the Marauder, and the Awesome. I'm going to start with the Valkyrie, which is plus 2 for elevation, plus 2 for cover, plus 2 for movement. A 10 to hit, what could possibly go wrong?
You never know.
Everything, as it seems, that was a... Whoops, I didn't want to pick that up. That was a 6, and... it missed. Alright, the Marauder is also going to shoot the Shadowhawk, which is also medium range. Plus 2. Yeah, it's also a 10 to hit, and I'm going to use the overheating for an additional point of damage in case I should hit. Which it does! Nice! So that would be... 3 points of damage to the Shadowhawk.
Okay. Now, do you have to roll for each point of structure damage?
No, as far as I understand it, per hit that does structure damage.
Okay, so yeah, you get to roll structure damage, critical hit.
2 or a 12 would be nice. Ah, crap. It's a 7, and a 7 means MP hit. I have no idea what the MP stands. Ah, the MP means I hit your gyro.
Movement.
So, yeah. Your movement is halved.
Is there a way to mark that on the card?
Yep, I have those. The red bag holds red small chips, and they are small enough that they fit exactly on the points on the mech sheet.
Those are tiny.
Yep. So that was the Marauder, if I'm not mistaken.
Yep.
Alright then. Okay, the Awesome would probably do the same, which is. Oh god. Plus 2 for the woods, plus 2 for movement, plus 2 for cover, plus 2 for medium range. Yeah, I'm going to need a 12 to hit that bloody annoying thing. Oh well, stranger things have happened. Well, that is one of the sixes I would have needed. Damn it. Okay,
and
the Hunchback is... 8... is medium ranging the Atlas, so there is elevated terrain, which means plus 2 and plus 2 for... range, that would be an 8. The Atlas moved, so that is going to be a 9. Come on, pick up the dice. Nope. Not going to cut it. And the Marauder goes kaboom. Well, I'm sure he did his best. Well, technically it did. He did hit before he died.
Hmm. Yeah. It's good damage.
That would be a 6 to your 7. Meaning I have to go first. Huh. Not the most comfortable position to be in. No, sir. Well, the Valkyrie is going to jump over here.
For having the movement, do you round up or down?
That is a very good question, sir. Check if you can find it. Because I think it doesn't say on the sheet. MP. Loses. Rounded normally. So, mathematically. So, 0.5 means you round up. Yep.
Okay.
Which could also mean that your TMM is lowered. To find the list for that. Target movement modifier. How much movement does he have left now?
3.
6 inches, right?
Yeah.
Okay, so his TMM is now only plus 1. No longer a plus 2.
Okay. Alright.
Alright. Going head to head with an Atlas. That is not going to be fun. The Awesome doesn't care about heat, so that doesn't matter at all. Huh. Two, three, four. Going to walk over here. Alright, Awesome moved. Closing in for the kill, are we? To your back, so I can just stay here and hope to pound the Atlas some more.
And my Warhammer is gonna maintain its position to reduce heat.
You can move. You just can't shoot. And you should probably move because being stationary makes you easier to hit. But you can move.
So, if I just go under the water then, would that reduce the heat?
Yes. If you have only one point of heat and don't use your overheating this round, then just stepping into ending your movement in water would eliminate that point of heat at the end of the round. Okay, that was movement, I take it? Yeah, I think so. Okay. Oh crap. So well, the good news is there's no elevated terrain between the Valkyrie and the Shadowhawk. The bad news is there is woods between the Valkyrie and the Shadowhawk. And it's still medium range. Wow, I could technically damage it. So that is a plus 4, and the Shadowhawk moved, so a plus 5. So that is a 9 to hit at medium range. Well, let's see if the Valkyrie can do something before it dies. Bloody hell, it does 1 point of damage on the Shadowhawk.
Roll your crit.
A 10. The camera. 10 fire control hit. Nice.
That take effect.
Nope, damage only takes effect at the end of the round because the firing all happens simultaneously. So then the Awesome is going to shoot at... Huh, actually, is it going to shoot the Atlas? The Warhammer already took some damage, right? Right, then I'm going to shoot the Warhammer. So that is... Yeah, well, short range, no cover, no nothing. Cool. A straight 4 to hit. Famous last words.
Yeah!
I had to bloody say it! I had to bloody say it! Duh. Pilot of the Awesome, you're fired. Okay, Then the Hunchback is going to fire at the Warhammer, and that is straight medium range with no cover. So a 6 to hit. Oh my god, finally somebody who can do his bloody job.
Plus oop.
Oh shit, because he moved plus 1, so nope, he doesn't hit also. You are right.
My turn?
Yeah, it's your turn. Well, that's what I get for messing with Wolf's Dragoons.
Alright, the Shadowhawk.
Alright, so you have to shoot through wood, so that's at least that is plus 2. Hold on a second. The TMM for the Valkyrie is 2, so that's a 6 because of the range is 8, so that's a 10 to hit. No, it's a 12 to hit because you took a hit to your firing controls.
Yeah, but that doesn't take effect.
Oh yeah, right. Sorry. Getting ahead of myself. Yes, so it's a 10 to hit. Nope.
So I guess Warhammer on.
Well, that, yeah, so both the
cover and move, right?
The five. Also moved, right, so that's a plus 1 for the movement, but it's short range, so it's a 5 to hit, yeah. For both the Atlas and the Warhammer. Well, that is it.
That's 3 damage.
3 damage to the awesome. Yep.
Yep.
And another hit.
For 5.
5. Oh, 5. God. AK-20s, ladies and gentlemen, not fun when they are used against you at point-blank range. Luckily, that is an awesome, and he has a lot of armor, or if I would use the correct time in that sentence, he had a lot of armor. Now he doesn't have any, but no structural damage yet. Whew. All right. That was everything, I'd take it, so next round. Well, that would be an 11. Me technically still right range, but me. Yeah, you know what? 4-5, the Valkyrie is going to jump back into the woods. That was... The standoff was so brutal.
Man.
Okay.
Are those two locked in combat? Can they move, or how does that?
Nope. There's as far as I have read in the books, there's nothing like you can engage in physical combat also, but there's no such thing as being locked in combat. You can basically freely move as long as you have hexes or field or area around you where you can legally move to.
Okay.
So basically, what I probably should do is try to inflict the maximum amount of damage before I die. Which means the awesome is going to walk 1, 2, 3. And we'll shoot the Warhammer in the back. I think. Hold on a second, is that... Oh, damn it. Is that a shot in the back? I need a line, so that is about the center. That is the center. No, that is not shooting you in the back. Fuck. Oh well. That I placed it, so it's my movement. Your turn. Mechs don't count as cover for when regarding line of sight.
That's fine.
Okay. So yeah, it's medium range, medium range, medium range. Yeah, screw it. The Hunchback is going to keep lurking in the woods.
Ew.
Right, then... Yeah. Time to shoot.
Shadowhawk, shoot it. Shadowhawk's gonna shoot it.
Awesome. Mhm. So that is medium range plus 2 through woods plus 2 and yeah, he moved plus 1, so that right. Is a 9 and 11 to hit.
Yeah. Almost impossible.
Yeah. Stranger things.
Warhammer's gonna shoot at. Warhammer's gonna shoot at the Valkyrie.
Plus 2 for medium range, and plus 2 for cover, and plus 2 because the Valkyrie moved. So, a 10 to hit. Oh!
Yeah.
Oh my god. Yeah, that is one very dead Valkyrie. Ouch.
Or
yeah, well, the Valkyrie had 1 point of internal structure left, so...
And the Atlas is gonna attack. Five.
Alright.
Five.
So, do I still have an awesome? Yes! He has 1 point of internal structure left. Roll for critical, please. 12. Yeah, no, there is no awesome. Result of 12 on the critical hit table means unit is destroyed. That was a headshot. There won't be anything left to salvage. Okay, so then it's my time, my turn for the last time with two of my mechs. No, to hit. There was something like, if I jump, attacker is indirectly. No. Wasn't there something of, if I jump, it's harder to attack, I think, which I totally missed. Yeah, if I jump, it's harder for me to hit. That's going to suck big time.
How does that affect the movement?
It doesn't affect movement, but if you jump, you have +2 on your attack rolls. Which okay. I totally missed, but I'm going to factor it in for the Valkyrie because it jumped. So that means medium range is a +2. There is cover, which is a +2. I jumped, which is a +2. And the Shadowhawk moved, which is a +1. So that is a +7. So I need an 11 to hit the Shadowhawk. Oh well. No. Okay. Then the awesome is going to shoot. I probably can't kill the Warhammer. Could try to kill the Shadowhawk. The Shadowhawk would be at a +5. The Warhammer only at a +1. Yeah, screw it. Let's go for the Warhammer and hope for a lucky roll on the critical hit table. +1, so 5 to hit. For a moment there, I was really scared. That is a 7 that is going to hit the Warhammer at short range and is going to do 3 damage.
Roll your critical.
And crit is going to be a 10.
Movement.
Movement again. Crap. A 10 is a firing control. Hit. Not movement.
Dang it.
Well, not exactly what I was hoping for, but not too shabby. Right, and the Hunchback. Probably can't even see the Warhammer, or can it? Yes, it can see the Warhammer. Wow, because mechs don't count as cover. That is nice. So that is 1, 2, 3.
What about terrain?
And the terrain counts, so the Warhammer has a partial cover. So it's medium range +2, partial cover +2, and the Warhammer moved +5. So that is a 9 to hit. Well, let's see. Nope. And that would be the end of this round with an awesome and a Valkyrie going up in flames. And 2 more mechless pilots.
Yeah, there should be no need to roll initiative since I outnumber you 3-1.
Well, the first It's even more true because the first thing I would do once it is my turn is surrender. Because 3-1 with a Warhammer and an Atlas against a Hunchback. No. Bloody no. Oh man. Well, congratulations to Wolf's Dragoons for successfully defending this planet and kicking my ass just pretty much the way I was expecting it to happen.
I didn't expect this at all. It's been years since I played this, so it was fun.
It's been 15 years or so since I last played it, and back then I played the original classic BattleTech, and when I read the rules, I thought it would be even faster and Max would die even faster than they did. But I think it's actually really, really balanced really well. It's not too
I would agree.
It's not too fast. You have time to maneuver and positioning comes into play, but it's fast enough that when you have a heavy and an assault standing in your face, then you are going to die. So that was
I mean, like the old BattleTech took forever. Like you needed 15 hits just to take off an arm.
Yeah. So overall, I'm really pleased with this. This is fun. So, yeah, I think I can and I will work with this as soon as I can find 3 replacement pilots and replacement mechs.
It makes me want to go out and buy the books for this now.
Yeah, I bought the PDF and printed it because I had a look at the import prices for the hardcover book, and for that money I can just print it myself and it will be a lot cheaper. Would be like $80 to get me the book.
Yeah, and if you get it spiral bound, it can lay flat. I prefer doing that usually.
Yeah, I do my own printing, and I also do my own binding. So bought a machine for that a while ago. So that comes in really handy.
Yeah, I think it only cost me like $6 to get a spiral bound, so it's not terrible.
Yeah, that's very reasonable indeed. Cool. So, thank you very much. This was fun. It was really cool.
Yeah, thanks. You want to do it again, just let me know.
Yeah, absolutely. Oh, we are so going to do this again. Okay, then I'm going to see you later with even more mayhem.
Yep, I got to take a shower, do some other